Welcome everybody to the 416 today. We're gonna do two things. One, plug my device in because it is gotta get it plugged in. And two, hang on a second. I've got Macy in sunglasses and a hat here. How in the world do we do that? All right. So I'm gonna plug this in while Ruby and Macy play Silver Bells. So done it a couple times and we'll give it a try. All right, beautiful.
First Noel.
All right, welcome everybody to the 416, and thanks Ruby and Macy for joining me for a couple of these songs today. We'll just make sure it's working well here. Personal love. 416, and we're glad that you have joined us, and we're going to sing another song here. This one we haven't done this way, and we hope it translates through the little tiny speakers on the phone. Little Drummer Boy.
Thank you.
today. Lord, I want to thank you for an opportunity to meet for the 416, and thank you for the opportunity to be together as a church during this time, even virtually. Thank you for the blessing of Christmas and your coming to us. And we just want to live in that joy. And we ask this in Jesus' name. Amen. Just a couple more things here this afternoon. And one, I appreciate all the different comments and ways that people engage on the 416. And so we'd love to have you as we wind down here. We've only got one more 416 before the season comes to an end. Who knows what else may happen with all this, but we had our summertime and fall 416, so those kind of came to a close, and then we wound up with this 416, which I thought was cool for Advent. And so in the comments, if you're watching today or if you watch this later, I would love just to hear one or two lines, you know, kind of like the back of a book. Where you see the endorsements from people saying, hey, this book is great, or this thing was good, or whatever. And I know some people do that naturally here and there, but just an invitation to make a comment and share one of these 416s that you've loved over the last few weeks. And maybe just, you know, say, hey, these have been great, or I love the afternoon 416s, or whatever you like to say, just to add that witness to these social media channels, which I think is awesome. And speaking of witness, today I read Psalm 103, and as I was reading Psalm 103, sitting just on the other side of the camera here in the recliner, I thought, here's a thought came to me. I thought, this is my new favorite psalm. And I just read through it thinking, man, I want to have that kind of joy this Christmas, no matter what is coming our way, no matter how things play out, no matter what's happening, I want to have this kind of joy. And so Psalm 103, and I'll read it to you from evidently a Bible that has like 8-point font here in this light, maybe less, but here we'll go. Let all that I am praise the Lord. With my whole heart I will praise his holy name. Let all that I am praise the Lord. May I never forget the good things he does for me. He forgives all of my sins and heals all of my diseases. He redeems me from death and crowns me with love and tender mercies. He fills my life with good things. My youth is renewed like that of the eagles. The Lord gives righteousness and justice to all those treated unfairly. He revealed his character to Moses and his deeds to the people of Israel. The Lord is compassionate and merciful, slow to get angry, and filled with unfailing love. He will not constantly accuse us, nor remain angry forever. He does not punish us for all our sins. He does not deal harshly with as we deserve. His unfailing love toward those who hear him is as great as the heights of the heavens above the earth. And a few more verses later, at the end of Psalm 103, it says, praise the Lord, you angels, you mighty ones who carry out his plans, listening for each one of his commands. Yes, praise the Lord, you armies of angels who serve him and do his will. Praise the Lord, everything he has created, everything in all his kingdom. Let all that I am praise the Lord. So I read that verse and just had a sense that I just want to keep things really simple. The common denominator, the basics this Christmas is this. We praise the Lord. We trust his name. We thank him for being kind and slow to anger and compassionate toward us, even in our weakness. We have a simple life of saying, Lord, all kinds of things are happening in us and around us, and we still say, we thank you, we trust you, and we love you. And so that's why I was thinking today I would just sing Away in the Manger, because that's one of them that sort of we think of often as kids singing. And so we want to have that kind of faith. And here's another old hymn that I also, it's not even an old hymn, but it's in the Methodist hymnal. And it's a song called Emmanuel, Emmanuel. So I'm just going to sing this kind of slow today and let us hear these words, and then we'll wind up. Christmas story, not just this coming week, but also next week and the month after and the month after, is that we have this confidence that God has come and that God is coming, and that living in and through us, working and being at work in us, God is making a difference in lives all around. And so we just want to trust Him with all that we have. So thanks again for listening, and thanks to Ruby and Macy way over there now for playing violin and singing a little bit, and a couple other special words here, and then we'll conclude. One is, thanks, I left my guitar strap at the church, and so I borrowed Ruby's, that's why I have a pink guitar strap today. And for whatever reason, I also have a pink guitar pick on this guitar sitting here at home, and so they were laughing at me because it's all pink. So what else are you going to do? You have 2 daughters. And the other thing I thought I'd mention is that today's my brother's birthday. So he's probably not watching the 416, but in case somebody knows him and knows that he, in case somebody's connected, you can just know that it's his birthday. So happy birthday to my brother. And I think that was all I was going to share. So thanks again for listening. Tomorrow is Andy wrapping up the 416s, and then Wednesday and Thursday, we are doing the outdoor worship services for Candlelight Christmas at 3:30 and 5 p.m. both Wednesday and Thursday. We're praying for no rain during the services, and we're praying for weather that can be not too awful cold, but it looks like in the forecast we have a little bit of both of those, so we'll just hope and plow through either way. And then, as a reminder, the online worship on Christmas Eve, 7 o'clock in the Family Life Center online streamed, and 11 o'clock in the Sanctuary online streamed. So no in-person for those just watching, and we hope that you can join us. All right, we appreciate you being here, and have a rest of a great day, and if I don't see you somewhere along the way this week, Merry Christmas.